And you can tell everybody that this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is now you're in the world. I sat on a roof and I kicked off the moss. You see these verses, well, they got me quite cross. But the sun's been kind when I wrote this song. It's for people like you that keep it turned on. Excuse me for getting about these things that do. You see, I've forgotten if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing is, you've got the sweetest eyes I've ever seen. Welcome back, everyone, to 5 at 5 Live. This is episode 6. We are back. I've had family in town for 2 weeks, and it was so fun, but it's so glad to be back here with you guys. Here we go.
And you can tell everybody that this is our song. It may be quite simple, but now it's done. I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is now you're in the world. I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is now you're.
Oh, alrighty, that was your song from one of my very favorite movies, Moulin Rouge. If you've not seen Moulin Rouge yet, you must. I saw it in high school, and I'm telling you, when I saw Ewan McGregor and Nicole Kidman singing in that movie, it made me want to do it. I was like, I have to do that. I remember when I watched the movie, I turned to my stage manager during one of the musicals I was doing in high school, and I was like, that's what I want to do. And she was like, well, then do it. And I was like, oh, okay. A few weeks ago, I sang Come What May from that movie, which, as I described then, I sang in front of the whole school at boarding school to my best friend Morgan to ask her to prom. Thankfully, she said yes, or it would have been a very never been kissed situation for me. But Ewan McGregor's voice in that is just like, it's so cool and so confident and so clear. I'd be curious to hear how it sounds like not on a recording, because I don't know why he doesn't have an album out by now, but it's really cool how he took on Elton John's song in like a totally new and inventive way. And I'm telling you, this song makes me boo-hoo. If you haven't seen it, it's a ton of covers of a lot of amazing, amazing artists of the 90s and early aughts. And it's a movie about acceptance and tolerance and grief and pain and love and sadness. And it's epic. All right. So next we have a song from a country duo called Dan and Shay. This song was actually written by Justin Bieber, surprisingly. It's called 10,000 Hours. I kind of have a crush on someone right now. And it's so fun to feel like flirty and giggly and warm and tingly, all glittery here. And this song kind of reminds me of that feeling. It's also just like super catchy. When this song first came out, I listened to it over and over. I don't know if y'all are like that, but when a song comes out and I love it, which right now for me is like so many K-pop songs, I just listen to it over and over and over and over and over because I can never, ever, ever get enough. So anyway, this is 10,000 Hours from Dan and Shay.
drunk at a friend's with your party. Do you think of me when you close your eyes? Doesn't make you smile. When you close your eyes, tell me what are you dreaming? Everything I wanna know it all. I'd spend 10,000 hours and 10,000 more. Oh, if that's what it takes to earn that sweetheart of yours. And I might never get back, but I'm gonna try. If it's 10,000 hours for the rest of my life, I'm gonna love you. Do you miss the road that you grew up on? Did you get your middle name from your grandma? When you think about you forever now, do you think of me? When you close your eyes, tell me what are you dreaming? Everything I wanna know at all. I spend 10,000 hours and 10,000 more. Oh, if that's what it takes to learn the sweet heart of yours. And I might never get there, but I'm gonna try. If it's 10,000 hours, oh, rest of my life, I'm gonna love you. I'm gonna love you. Yeah, yeah. Oh, all the good and the bad, everything in between. Oh, gotta cure my curiosity. Oh, yeah, yeah. It's been 10,000 hours and 10,000 more. Oh, if that's what it takes to learn the sweetheart of yours. And I might never get back, but I'm gonna try. If it's 10,000 hours or the rest of my life, I'm gonna love you.
Oh, it's so nice to be back in this 5 at 5. I want to say hi to Maddie Bear. We've got Justin Dawson here, my Aunt Erin. Hi, Mandy. Hi, Lavage. We've got so many fun people here. This is so fun. Hi, Kevaru. Hi, Ruby. Georgia. Jess. Ricker is on the show, who we're going to be featuring later for the fifth song. She's going to be doing a very snarky astrological read, so stick around. As we know, we love the astrologies here at 5 at 5, so it's going to be hilarious. Pandemic. Let's talk about it. We're all thinking about it. It can't seem to leave the consciousness anytime soon. I don't know about you guys, but like sometimes I'm okay and I'm thriving, and then sometimes I'm just like, I don't understand what is going on. I think this pandemic kind of like rings the fight or flight alarm in us, which makes us react so strongly to people and situations in a very like survival mode way. I know I personally been popping off on people left and right and not even really meaning to. And afterwards I'll be like, where was the love? Where was the compassion? You know, if you're feeling off one moment and on top of the world the next, you're perfect right where you are. I have to keep reminding myself, just take a deep breath, keep trudging along and doing things that make you feel fulfilled and motivated. Because the problem is when we start wallowing and we sulk, we get lost in that dark hole of misery. And our brains and our egos are not like super equipped for this kind of global response. I mean, if you consider yourself an empath like I do, you might be waking up just feeling all kinds of crazy without even getting a chance to ease into the day. So you're not alone. And like I said, if someone pops off on you at like the supermarket or cuts you off on the street, cut that cord of the bad energy and show some love and empathy to this fellow human just trying to make it through this day. Because that's really, at the end of the day, what we're all trying to do is just figure this all out. And the leadership in the countries around the world are not super helping. So it's up to us. You know, next time you walk to next to someone and they don't smile back, you just say, okay, I wish you well for today. But speaking of people that are doing amazing things for their community, Pat O'Neill, who is a legend here in Gunnison County, which is where I'm at in the beautiful Crested Butte, Colorado, is running his 10th 100-mile race, and he's already raised $46,000 for Living Journey clients. Living Journeys provides financial grants, emotional support, and enrichment programs to the Gunnison County residents affected by cancer. So this next song, we're going to be like cutting and clipping for them. So get into it. Hi, beautiful people. This song is being sung directly to Living Journey clients and all people living with cancer. No one should face cancer alone. I love you and I believe in you and your journey. You can do this. And we're all here for you, rooting for you every step of the way. This is Lean On Me by Bill Withers. Feel free to sing along because this is for you. Song that's been redone a bajillion times, but Bill Withers, the OG soul, talking about some real shit. All right, this next song is from one of my very favorite musicals called Dear Evan Hansen. It's a song called Waving Through the Window. And when I saw this musical, I was kind of shocked because it brought up a lot of old feelings of abandonment and grief that I have related to bullying I experienced in school. There was kind of a dark memory that came up when I was thinking about singing this song, and it was in fourth grade. I went to a public elementary school, and we all had to like line up according to grade in the gym before school started. Why? I have no idea. But I remember one day I walked in fourth grade, and I'd always been kind of a fun, free, like flamboyant person up until then, just totally myself all the way. And this kid, Joe, I won't say his last name because people improve and grow and evolve over time. So perhaps his story is different now. But I remember he got up and he goes, "Look, it's the faggot." And everyone in the school, or my perception as a fourth grader, I was like seven then, started laughing and pointing and calling me a faggot. And I remember thinking like, oh my gosh, why? Why am I even having to experience that? And that experience brought me into this crazy, shy, non-open, non-loving self, and it really affected my self-esteem. So I remember when I was watching Dear Evan Hansen and this song came on, I just thought it was so cool how this show successfully portrayed the experience of self-esteem and loss and the art of trying to just fit in. And this song I particularly relate to because I felt like a total outsider growing up, you know, different and flamboyant in North Carolina, and wondering if there will ever be a day when I feel accepted, or will I just wave through the windows waiting to be seen? So this is Waving Through the Window by Dear Evan Hansen, who was written by Patrick and Paul.
Learn to slam on the brake before I even turn the key, before I make a mistake, before I leave with the worst of me. Give them no reason to stare, no slipping up if you slip away. So I got nothing to share. No, I got nothing to say. Step out of the sun if you keep getting burned. Step out of the sun because you've learned, because you've learned. On the outside, always looking in, will I ever be more than I've always been? Cause I'm tap, tap, tapping on the glass. I'm waving through a window, oh why? Try to speak when nobody can hear, so I wait around for an answer to appear while I'm watching people pass. I'm waving through a window. Can anybody see? Is anybody waving? Start believing that we belong, but every sun starts to rise, and no one tells you where you went wrong. Step out of the sun if you keep getting burned. Step out of the sun because you've learned. On the outside, always looking in, will I ever be more than I've always been? Cause I'm tapping on the glass. I'm waving through a window. I ain't trying to speak, but nobody can hear. So I wait around for an answer to appear while I'm watching people pass. I'm waving through a window. Can anybody see? Is anybody waving? When you're falling in a forest and there's nobody around, do you ever really crash or even make a sound? When you're falling in a forest and there's nobody around, do you ever really crash or even make a sound? When you're falling in a forest and there's nobody around, do you ever really crash or even make a sound? When you're falling in a forest and there's nobody around, do you ever really crash or even make a sound? Would I even make a sound? Would I even make a sound? It's like I'll never make a sound. Will I ever make a sound? On the outside, always looking in, will I ever be more than I've always been? Cause I'm tapping on the glass. I'm waving through a window. I try to speak, but nobody can hear. So I wait around for an answer to appear while I'm watching people pass. I'm waving through a window. Can anybody see? Is anybody waving back at me? Is anybody waving? Waving? Oh, oh, oh,
oh. It does get better though, folks. It really always does. Thank you for letting me share my story here at 5 at 5 always. I am really excited because this is the first time, so this is the sixth episode. We're going to do something a little special for the last song. Usually it's an acapella song, but this time we are going to welcome my dear friend, Jess Rickert. We used to live together in college, and we've shared many, 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 many experiences together, and she's going to get on and do a little set. Let's go ahead and welcome Jess to the stage. Let's see if she's going to request herself in. Here she comes. Everybody put your hands together for Jess Rickert, the comedian, the hilarious. Woo! How are you?
Patrick. I'm good. How are you? You sound fantastic today.
Thank you, honey. I cannot wait to hear what you have. So I want to ask you, how are you doing during the pandemic?
Well, not as good as, you know, before the pandemic, but right. Clearly, you know, it's been hard. I think the hardest thing for me is social gatherings and not being able to have fun with my friends. Like when you and I would watch Project Runway on the couch, can't really do that with friends anymore.
Thursday nights.
Yeah, Thursday nights. And then we'd have runway catwalk offs.
With blanket wigs. We love a good blanket wig.
Absolutely. But the way that I've been really avoiding the stress from that is putting myself into random hobbies, like paint by numbers. I paint rocks now.
Ooh, I love that for you.
Mm-hmm. Good time. Well, so what I was going to do today for your audience was I wanted to follow along the same theme is what you've done for previous weeks. Sometimes you'll pull a tarot card.
Oh, yeah.
And I thought that was fun, but you're all about love and light, whereas I'm all about snarkiness. So I have these Lisa Frank tarot cards.
Yes.
And I thought maybe your crowd would enjoy that because we're all 90s babies or 80s babies. So.
Oh, yeah. We're all Crystal-y and Juju here.
Awesome. Well, I wanted to start off from the top with the Aries. Aries, some people might call you stubborn. They might say that you're bullheaded. I don't subscribe to any of those for you. One thing I will say is that you are a conspiracy theorist. And right now, you are wearing that tinfoil hat proudly. You go, girl. Maybe back down a little bit because you're affecting other people's mental health right now, though. And reading a Facebook article, an expert doesn't make. So maybe back out of the conspiracy theories for now. That for you is the Hierophant card. You see that? Happens. Cute. Next is Taurus, living her best life on the couch right now. You do you. You're saving lives, honey child. Just keep doing it. We appreciate
you. Taurians here in the audience right now.
Oh, yeah. Well, they get the Hermit.
The Hermit.
Mm-hmm. Gemini, this has been a rough one for you because of your mind just spinning wheels, constantly thinking about all the anxiety. For you, that translates into a bit of a digestive tract issue sometimes. So what I would say is maybe cut out the gluten or stop drinking. Although that makes me a raging hypocrite. But for legal purposes, this is Sprite.
Because the Geminis will come for you otherwise.
They will. But your card is the Lovers.
Ooh.
The Twins, the Lovers. All right, Cancer. Now, I know that this social distancing thing has been rough for you, which is why you're not doing it. It doesn't mean you should wear out your credit card right now. Stop buying things. Stop buying things. Put it back. Your Amazon cart needs to just go away for now. Put it away. So for you, you get the Wheel of Misfortune by getting the name Cancer. So Wheel of Misfortune. And then Leo, no one is wearing a bra right now. Why are you? Why are you still wearing makeup? And like looking cute and going out and like, you're still doing your thing. I respect that, but also maybe do what the rest of us did a long time ago and just give up. Leo gets the Empress.
Ooh, pretty card.
Pretty kitty. Next is Virgo. Now this is you, Patrick. If there is a sign on this planet that would copyright the term this bitch, it would be Virgo, because you are judgmental.
Great.
I would say for right now, let's let the judgment lie for a second, because we're all struggling in this together. You get the judgment card.
Oh. All right.
And then Scorpio. We literally have nothing else going on in our lives right now. How are you still late for everything? You don't have anything going on, girlfriend. Just make it on time. Make it on time. I would say that even if you do show up, because sometimes you flake out, but if you do show up, you're still a really good time. You're a raging party, so you get the devil.
Lavage is loving that.
Yep. And Libra, yeah, Libra, that one, you don't have a COVID problem. You're not dying. You just have a headache. Maybe take some Tylenol. The hypochondriac in you is going crazy right now. So I'm going to need you to like calm that down and just realize, take a breath. I'm not dying. I'm fine. I don't need to go to the doctor again this week. It's okay.
And you have
your own form of justice. Libra gets justice because they're the scales.
I live.
And then Sagittarius, I know you love your freedom. Maybe keep your freedom to yourself. We can't travel right now. That passport of yours is no good, unfortunately. So my recommendation for you and your zodiac astrology thing for this week is maybe decorate a bedroom like another country and go to that bedroom and take an edible or two and act like you're traveling. That'll feed the need for your travel bug for now. Now, Sagittarius is hilarious with their friends, so you get the pool.
Ooh, the pool.
Okay, so next we have Capricorn. Ooh, Capricorn, this work from home situation is really letting you become an absolute workaholic, isn't it? You are just sitting in your house all the time. Girl, go outside. See the sun. It'll help your skin tone a little bit better. So you need sun. Go outside and see it.
Get the sun, Cappies. Come on, little goats.
They're so ambitious. They need to go see some sunlight every now and then. Now, I like to do Aquarius because that's my sign. So clearly I know how to roast an Aquarius. Right now, like I said earlier, Aquarius, you are driving yourself nuts with projects all over the place. But if there's one thing about an Aquarius, it's if you go up and talk to someone about the pandemic, they're the one person that's going to be like, that's still a thing. That's still happening. You are so aloof. Maybe just pick up a newspaper every now and then. It's okay. Also, like I might have told Sag to go take an edible to act like she's traveling, but you need to calm it on the drugs there, Aquarius. You get the high priestess. And then Pisces, now is your time to shine. You love to take care of other people, so you're getting to do that, and you're doing it very well. I will say that I roasted Aries for being a conspiracy theorist, but you are the one that believes it. You are the gullible one, and there is no cure for being gullible. It's just pay a little more attention to what's going on. Also, essential oils can't solve everything. So, but just gonna put that out there. You get temperance.
Ooh.
And I know that Pisces love hummingbirds, so that's why you have a hummingbird on yours. I will also say, Pisces, I can tell Sagittarius to go take an edible, but I can't tell you to do that, because then you just won't stop taking them. So And that's what I had today.
Oh my God. That is hilarious. Oh my God. We were so lucky to have you. That was amazing. You know, you just got to laugh every once in a while. And I appreciate you so much. You are hilarious. Everyone go to Jess's page, follow her. She's got so many cool things going on. She's from North Carolina and she's a very dear friend. I consider her family. So everyone give them some love on the hearts over here. Thank you, Jess.
Thanks for having me. Bye, Patrick. Love you.
All right, everyone. That was 5 at 5, episode 6. I'm so glad you were here. I love you so much. And we will see you next Sunday. Mwah.